Hey guys, welcome back to shapeit. So today we're gonna look into Solidworks furniture design again. We are at episode 20. It's been a long time. I have not uploaded a few things. Like I'm very happy, like we are now 1,500 subscribes, so I think I'm doing good. So hope you two are doing good in the way of health and wealth. And so without wasting much time, let's get started with a new design. So today I'll come up with a request from the Insta. So one of a friend has been posted a image. He wants to like how to create in Solidworks and how to create that as you have seen in the thumbline. So here the Solidworks which I have been done a new part. I'm gonna select the top line. From there we're gonna start the base and how to create that. So that the friend has sent from the Walmart. He has seen that, like how can we design such a structural and to create that kind of a chair or sofa something for his home. So I'm gonna make a rough dimension so you guys can customize like how you want as per your requirement. So I'm gonna start with the unit, so you can also modify according to your units. So I'm gonna select the top line. Here I'm gonna select again on the circle. This is a sketch where I'm gonna select the circle. So created. After that, I'm gonna mention 600 dia. This is overall a base dia for that, and I'm gonna create a 20 with what I have decided a structural. Okay, so and then on the future gonna do an extrude base, so blind, and I'm gonna select again 20. This is what I have decided, 20 20. In overall, if you see the overall the structure will looks 20 mm, but based on your standard, like you can be fixed. So this has been done in a wood or in a steel, however it's all about your preference. So I'm gonna select now on the top, I'm gonna select the center line to give the support for this, and then exit from the sketch, go for again a boss extrude. This all can be done in at single, but just to show like however you want, you guys can decide on the way how. So 20 I want it has to be, and this to be done in the mid, and we have to flip it so that it will be okay for us. Yep, it can be done at single sketch, so I just want to make sure it should be flipped and it should be at the center. Yep, so the base is ready, and the bottom however, like if you guys want, you can create a nylon or some good cushion for to support the whole body. For time being, I'm gonna create this should be offset from this around 10, and here this should be at center line, and my cushion could be 20 or 18, so like very close to that. So again, I'm gonna select the circular pattern sketch. In this, I'm gonna select this my center and the entity which I would like to have this. And this I'm gonna remove. Yep, so there are four. So based on your size and this, like you can increase. So for now I'm gonna go with a 6. Yep, and then exit from the sketch again. I'll go for an extrude on 20 again if you want, or you can make it as 15. This you have to screw it according to your standard which is available in your local market, so that you can take it up. Yep. So our base is already perfect. So now I'm going to go again a sketch here. Now flip it. Gonna convert entity offset, select convert entity and convert the same the outer diameter, and I'm on offset around 20. That's what we have decided to go with, and make an offset line which away from center 100 mm. I'm gonna delete this over like yeah, and also I'm gonna make this yes, this is what we need at one center. This is not required. Let it be this, and this should be coincident. So this is constraint. Flip it. I'm gonna make 500 the height of the chair, but still like according to your need you can decide however you want. So I'm gonna remove the mesh result here. So this is going to be a separate entity. So and then select this sketch, I mean the face. Later on from here to here, cover up this from here to here 25. This makes sense. And gonna do extrude cut through all, remove. So I just want to create this way, and also we'll create a flat to maintain a smooth surface at one side. I'm gonna select okay. 100 should be fine according to your need. Yes, again, so in this I want to make it a shell. So shell will help you to maintain equal thickness throughout this boundary. So I'm gonna select these two face in order to remove and maintain 20. Yes, looks good. So this is a one left side frame, and also accordingly we're gonna create a right side frame. Before that gonna create one more a small aesthetic supports, and that will help the overall chair to looks great, and also eventually we will be getting an enough support. Again, from here to here, as you know, that center will be 10. Yes, and this is gonna be a construction line. What I'm gonna do here is gonna make a center line this, and this to this it will be a 12.5. yes, and I would like to have 18 of a solid shaft. Either it should be in a wood or a solid of metal or a hollow pipe. So according to your need, you guys can decide. And well, if you are steel, it's well. If you are an wood, you have to make it as a proper fastness. I'm going with the circular pattern now. This is my entity circle, and again I want to remove this, and I want this circle to be circular pattern at one side, like 90 degree. I'm gonna flip it. Yes, this I would like to have somewhere on 6, and instant escape. I don't want this to be there. Yeah, this is enough for us, and also can go for an 8, makes sense a little bit. Yes, 8 makes sense, or yeah, 8. Okay, not to be 7, fine. Yep, select okay. Select, come out of the sketch, exit, and I'm gonna select extrude, select up to next so that it will align according to the profile. Yep, perfect. And you can always try to remove that option, the major result, so that you will have all the entities, all the solid bodies as a separate. You can take a dimension accordingly. Yeah, right. So the left is ready. And then I'm gonna do the mirror on the other side by selecting the body, this body, and accordingly I'm gonna select all the bodies. This is my face where I like to have a mirror, and I'm gonna select okay. Yeah, now I have two entities. Now you can have two screws or holes to tighten this for the customer, like whoever wants, so that it will be easy for us to deliver the part in a very limited package or a limited the box size. So don't make a combined in a frame, so make it as a left and right, so it'll be easy for us to send for a courier or something like that. That's how the wall part works. So accordingly I made this, and also you can at the bottom you can make again a fastness to tighten this. So the frame is ready. This is what you have been seen in the thumbnail. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select the face to show you how to create a fabric, a cushion or something like that. So you can guys make a clearance accordingly, according to your dimension. So this is 5mm, which I like to have. So again, extrude to some extent, like around 200. Yeah, that makes sense, quite enough. And remove this. Yeah, 200 makes sense for me. But according to your need and height, you guys can decide. Sorry. If I make sense, okay. Slightly, okay. Again, sorry guys, little bit cold. Yep. So again, go for a constraint. This is all about the cushion, which I'm talking about now. How to create a cushion for the sofa or a chair. Okay. Okay. This line I'm gonna create a trim this time. So this is what I just want to make sure at this half for the upper body to make sure we'll have a. Sorry, yes, to have a more cushion on the frame. So now you can extrude up to surface or offset from the surface. So you add off the offset like around 20 and flip the direction. So not 20, that looks great. 20 is pretty much enough, and remove this result from here. The cushion almost ready. Now I'm gonna flip in a direction. Yes. I'm gonna make this one. You will wonder why I'm getting this, but as you see in the timeline, I'm gonna split this. So always like make sure you have to pack and send to your customer, so that it will be like splitted. It'll be always easy for us. So 90 makes eventually on both sides. So I'm gonna do edit, then select this body, cut body. So I want this body, this body, this body has to be separated from each other. Yeah, I'm gonna hide this. Perfect now. So avoid this 50 each other, or in the bottom we can go with multiple radius. So this I just want to make a twin, something like this. And so this two should be a good radius. This all like it's all about customized thing, which you guys can decide how you want as per your customer. And while making the fabric or a cushion, you guys can decide. So this is all like a rough estimation which I'm showing here now, only this to show you how to create a dimensions in order to make. Sorry, only with the one fillet will work for that moment. quickly I'm going to select all the surfaces. I'm going to create this, and now I'm going to select this all at the back side and this also. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, perfect. So this is how I made that design, a cushion all left, right, or for the shoulders, and this is a frame. So likewise, you can customize your design. This design I'm going to upload in the GrabCAD. You can check out my link in the description and go and download at free. So at the same time, please do subscribe. That will help and motivate me to do a lot of stuffs in future. Also, I'm doing as I shown in my channel, I'm just playing around with the SolidWorks. So you have a macros, SolidWorks, printable, sheet metal, and component modeling. So many stuff are here to see. Please do subscribe, and that will motivate again, as I said, and I will do a lot of videos in future. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next wonderful product. Until then, bye from Shapeit. Thank you.